The field of graphic design encompasses a wide range of project types and many types of media, and skills that other designers need to learn might not be the same help that you're looking for. In this video, we'll explore the Learn Docker in CorelDRAW and Corel Photo Paint and demonstrate how customizing your profile can help you access relevant practice files to get you up to speed in the features most helpful for your work. Note that most of the features described in this video are relevant only for CorelDRAW subscribers. All users have access to the Learn Docker, but for non-subscribers, this Docker will contain only the Hints tab. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial. If you're a Corel subscriber, when you first open CorelDRAW or Corel Photo Paint, you'll be presented with the Personalization window. This is where you can tell us your experience level and the types of projects you work on most often. We'll link this information to your profile in order to curate learning content just for you. On the last page of the survey, you'll see one or more practice projects selected for you, based on your responses. The last icon is Explore More Tutorials, and clicking this icon takes you to the Learn Docker. If CorelDRAW or Corel Photo Paint is already open, the Learn Docker can be opened from the Window Dockers menu, or by clicking the plus icon below the current set of Docker tabs. On the Explore tab, available to subscribers only, you can enter a search term, such as logo, to find learning content on that topic. By default, the filter options are set to show all content, including tool hints, practice projects, written tutorials, videos, and help topics. The sorting option, recommended for you, lists content first that suits your profile. Switching to most recent shows recently added content first, and Most Relevant sorts the list to show the content most relevant to your search term. Clicking the X icon clears the search field. In my example, in which I'm using CorelDRAW, I'll filter to show only practice projects, and this list includes all practice projects for all types of users. The Recommended for You filter is handy for seeing practice projects that fit your profile, and switching to Most Recent may display new practice projects you haven't seen before. Clicking a practice project opens the file directly in CorelDRAW, where you'll find detailed steps for replicating the practice design. Let's say you've already been using CorelDRAW or Corel Photo Paint without having filled out the profile survey, or perhaps you did respond but now want to change or update your answers. Clicking the Personalize Results icon reopens the survey, which will list any previous answers. Updating your responses updates your profile, which enables us to show you the learning content most relevant to you. And clicking a practice project from this window also opens it directly. The other tab in the Learn Docker is Hints, available to all users, which provides learning content and tips for the currently active tool. The Learn More section has links to help topics and other relevant content. From this tab, you can also access the Ideas portal, where you can help contribute to CorelDRAW Graphics Suite's design and development. You can submit your own ideas and suggestions, and vote on ideas and suggestions made by others. The Ideas portal can also be accessed from the Welcome screen and from the CorelDRAW community site. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on the Learn Docker in CorelDRAW and Corel Photo Paint. If you've been watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on Corel's Discovery Center. Here you can also find a written version of this tutorial.